email newsletter is a compact, personalized, and engaging way of interacting with your audience. Think of a newsletter as a jack-of-all-trades type of tool. It can convince your readers to buy your product, it can educate them about the company's activities, or it can also keep them in the loop about upcoming special events, such as discounts, workshops, classes, and so on. Starting and maintaining a newsletter need not be a daunting task. As with any marketing channel or campaign, just flesh out a clear idea of what your newsletter is and follow through with some key principles. Are you wondering how you can get started? Hi, I'm Divya from Freshworks Academy. In this video, we'll talk about how you can create a newsletter that customers want to open. Decide the subject of your newsletter. Don't bite off more than you can chew. Decide which content and topics you want to put in your newsletter. Some helpful questions to ask yourself are, what type of content do our customers want? Why do our customers want this information from us? Do we want to sell our product or increase awareness or win new customers? Answering these questions will help you adhere to a framework as you create your newsletter. Who is your audience? Deciding who your reader is will help you shape your newsletter for exactly that persona. Is it a customer, a lead, a new signup? Once you boil that down, or if you have a newsletter for more than one persona, you'll be able to structure and tailor your content accordingly. Set expectations. The frequency of your newsletter will depend on the effort it involves and how achievable it is. Setting up a consistent schedule is the first step in creating an expectation among your readers. One classic principle to keep in mind is, never send important emails during closing time, say at 5 p.m. on a Friday. You can also dig a little deeper, knowing who your reader is and what your newsletter provides them. Is it a news roundup? Is it a weekly or a monthly newsletter? When would it make sense to send them a newsletter with a long support article? Maybe closer to the weekend. When would it make sense to send them a news roundup? Early on in the morning. Keep your content clear, concise, and useful. People look for value within the email itself. Keep this in mind if you find yourself using too many links that force the reader to leave the newsletter. Links are just an add-on. The value should be within the email itself. It's also helpful to craft a newsletter along the lines of a narrative or a story. This will guide your reader seamlessly. Your tone and style can play off that narrative and your product. Would it make more sense to be conversational and casual or crisp and urgent? Once you decide what content to go with, make sure it checks off these three boxes. It's clear, it's concise, and it's useful. The three qualities Google uses for its content strategy. The last thing readers want in their crowded inbox is yet another long email that doesn't serve them. Subject lines are key. Imagine working on a killer newsletter issue, complete with well-crafted content, a coherent narrative, full of insights. None of this will make it to your reader if you don't hook them with a compelling subject line. Some foolproof subject line tips are, keep them short. This helps you engage your reader at once, and it prevents your subject line from getting cut off by inbox margins. Consider who your audience is and what your issue is about when you decide on the tone of your subject line. Should it be leisurely or urgent, polite or playful, and so on. Conduct A-B testing to see which subject lines work well and which don't. Avoid using spammy words. You don't want your readers to mistake your newsletter for an ad or a junk email. Set up a welcome email. Once a reader signs up for your newsletter, it's a good idea to send them a welcome email, which informs them about what they can expect from your newsletter and how often they will receive it. Sending them a welcome email, besides being welcoming, of course, to your reader, helps reinforce their choice and it helps deliver your ideas to them immediately. Open up a space for interaction and feedback. Newsletters don't have to be passive. Asking your readers for feedback can do two things. One, it helps you improve your product and meet their needs. And two, it keeps them engaged by opening up a space for interaction. Some ways to do this in your newsletter are, ask them what they think of your newsletter and what it can do better. Ask them to send you their questions on a certain subject or topic. Ask them for recommendations, tips, suggestions that would help them feel like part of a community. Ask them to forward the issue to their friends and family if they like it, or to share it on social media. Another way to make your newsletter interactive is to collaborate and help other businesses grow. You can do this by calling out specific partners, including sponsors in your newsletter, or by featuring movers and shakers in your industry. Offer tailored newsletter options. Once you hit the ground running and gather a loyal community of readers, you can increase engagement by tailoring content for specific audiences. One way newsletters often do this is by offering tiered or premium subscriptions. For instance, you can offer your general audience a standard monthly issue, whereas you can offer your paid audience a bi-weekly issue with access to premium content, such as discounts, opportunities, sneak peeks, and so on. Another way to do this is by offering the reader the choice of the newsletter they'd like to receive, if you have the capacity to launch multiple types of newsletters. Would they like to get a newsletter featuring industry experts? Or would they like a newsletter based around industry trends? Or maybe one for job seekers and learners? Create a landing page. One way to get your newsletter into more inboxes is through word of mouth and social media engagement. If your readers like your newsletter, they will likely talk about it. And at that point, you should make it easy for new readers to sign up. That's where a landing page comes in. Use this landing page to introduce your newsletter and demonstrate what makes it distinctive. Tell your visitors what they can expect and gain from your newsletters. If your current readers have submitted good feedback, then include those reviews and testimonials to persuade your new readers to sign up. You can also use this page to archive newsletters. An archive serves as a ready repository for your current readers to access old issues at any time that they want. It also helps a potential new signup sample your work before they take action. For an introduction to landing page design, check out Freshworks Academy's Guide to Landing Page Design Principles in the description below. Finally, be consistent. This is true of any campaign or project where you want to maintain, sustain, and grow your audience. Keeping your newsletter consistent will ensure that your readers expect your emails, open them, and look forward to reading them as part of their day. You're set! With these tips in mind, your path to creating a newsletter and reaching your community just became that much easier. Are you planning on launching a newsletter soon? Let us know in the comments below. For more insightful content, sign up for Freshworks Academy. The link is in the description below. Until next time, bye and happy creating!